card. Okay. Okay. Ya, jadi mix biasanya di kelas ini talk in English 100% or 50-50?
Pakai bahasa Indonesia, Bu. Iya, Bu.
Talk in Indonesia
100%. Iya, Bu. Meskipun di sini internasional, tapi pakai bahasa Indonesia juga.
Kebanyakan dosen pakai bahasa Indonesia, Bu.
I thought before this is an international class, so I have to talk in English. Okay, tapi sebagai motivasi aja ya, kita sama-sama belajar.
Sama-sama belajar nggak, Bu?
Okay, talking it. Jadi, just interrupt me if you don't understand what I'm talking about. Bu, saya nggak paham gitu, misalnya. I will talk in Indonesia, okay? Okay, saya ulangin aja ya. Karena, because I record this every class, I will upload it on YouTube and embed on Learning JTE, so you can review or rewatch this class.
Ah, YouTube.
Okay. Is it clear?
Clear.
Okay. Clear. Let's start. Okay, my name is Intan Sulistianing Rumsakina. This is my curriculum vitae, short vitae about my education before I got my bachelor degree on in Universitas Negeri Malang, Department of Electrical Engineering. I graduated in 2017, and for the master degree, I got it from Universitas Gajah Mada. I just graduated on August 2020. Okay, for my working experience, I was a lab assistant for web programming at Electrical Engineering UM in 2015, and also a lecturer assistant when I was a graduated student at DTT UGM. DTT means Department of Electrical Engineering and Information Technology. I started on 2021. So basically, I just quit the job for a month ago, because I accepted as a lecturer in Poly J. And also, I was a researcher assistant at a Faculty of Engineering in UGM. Started on 2019 to February 2021. So I got two jobs as a part-time job during my college life. Okay. And this semester, I taught three courses. The first one is Komputer Dasar, MEF Regular Semester 2. And the second one is Management Basis Data, MEF Management Informatika ya, Regular Semester 4. Nah, yang tadi salah masuk ini, MEF Regular Semester 4. So I was confused. And the third is this international class, the special class, because I have to speak English during the class. Okay. Actually, I didn't have experience on business, but I'm trying to explain you. Okay, for the lecture implementation, for the synchronous pace, every week we do a synchronous class using Zoom or other platform. We can use another platform because the Zoom is limited. The yes. PolyJ is just have 6 account and have to share to another lecturer. So maybe next week I will use another platform. So we don't have to apa sih berebutan. I don't know the English though. And for the asynchronous,
using Google Meet, it's okay.
Yeah, Google Meet, it's free.
Yeah.
And as for the asynchronous, the assignment is I will upload on JTE Learning, and also this recording a lecture I will embed to the JTE Learning, so you can go through it, watch it there without going to YouTube application. Okay. Next, rules in online lectures, because this class is only have 5 students. It will be easy for me to check out my student who is absent, who is present today. Okay, please active in JTE e-learning. Study the material that has been uploaded there before the class. You also can read them. And so when the class is started, you can ask some question that you don't understand on the presentation files. Okay, and don't forget always fill out the attendance list during the class, do assignment on time, take UTS. UTS is middle test, and UAS is final test for the semester online or maybe not synchronous, because maybe this course the UAS will be a project. Okay, and active in learning lectures. Please join the class 5 minutes before the lecture it starts. This course is started at 2 p.m. 1 a.m. 1 p.m. I mean, because I'm in Wita. I'm not in Jember yet. So I thought this class is started at 2 p.m. in my place, of course. Okay, disable the microphone or mute in a mute mode if you're not want to ask or talk something to me. And when you're asking, please say your name first, so I will know you and you will know me also. And try to speak English when asking. It's okay if you mix the question with Indonesia, Bahasa Indonesia. Okay, this one is, I have said before, the recorded video of the lecture will be uploaded on YouTube after the class, and you can also check on my YouTube, but not ready yet so for today, because there's no video on my YouTube. There's no video on my YouTube, only after this class end. Or you don't have to check on my YouTube, you just go to the JTE e-learning. I will embed it there. So this is the overview for our lecture today, Information Business Services. So basically this course will discuss various aspects related to business activities, how to analyze the situation and trends of the ICT business, both at the national, regional, and international levels. Jadi perkuliahan ini akan mempelajari tentang aktivitas bisnis dan menganalisa situasi maupun tren-tren bisnis di bidang ICT, TIK. ICT itu TIK dari bisnis nasional, regional, maupun internasional. Kemudian, after you understand the, and being able to apply these two main subjects, you will be equipped with the understanding and ability to develop a business plan in the field of information technology, which includes aspects, legality, business functions, human resources, organization, marketing, and finance. Jadi ya dalam mata kuliah ini tuh nggak cuma berbicara tentang bisnis ICT itu apa aja yang udah berkembang, tapi juga kalian dibekali dengan bagaimana cara merencanakan sebuah bisnis yang akan berhubungan dengan ICT atau TIK. Bagaimana kalian dari segi legalitasnya, dari segi business function, terus human resource, SDM-nya seperti apa, dari segi organisasinya, marketnya, nanti target marketnya seperti apa, cara pemasarannya seperti apa, dan dari segi keuangannya. Jadi kalian seperti apa nanti bisa menentukan harga dari produk yang akan kalian jual. Seperti itu. So the topics of these courses, the first one is general topics about what is business, what is ICT, and what is business in ICT. And then for the second week is next week. For the third week, we will discuss about type of informatics business, and then information business development in Indonesia and the world or international levels. But I think for the first topic and the second topic could be delivered next week maybe, because type of informatics business is just talking about what is business in ICT related to ICT, like Google, Tokped, Sociola, and so on. And for the fourth, company establishment regulation and procedures. Fifth, human resources and organization. And the next is marketing aspects. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For the middle test, we stop at the topic marketing aspect, and we have middle test, and then after middle test, we continue the topics is regulation and procedures for the procurement of goods and service. Jadi regulasi dan prosedur dalam pengadaan barang dan jasa. And then source of information about ICT projects, offers, or opportunities. And then the need for documents contained in the term of references or TOR. Dan yang terakhir adalah case study, business presentation techniques. Jadi how you deliver your presentation to your user or your customer, so your customer will attract to your products. Okay, you know these logos, the green one, the blue one, the pink one. So what is it?
Tokopedia.
No, I mean this one.
Gojek.
Oh, yeah. You know how how the business process of this application?
Biasa antar.
Okay, for the first time they use a concept of Ojek online as Ojek untuk antar jemput aja yang pertama. And the second they built another features, another services to the customer. Second one is GoFood. The third one is GoLife, but now it already closed permanently because of the COVID. And for the second logo, what is it?
Tokopedia.
What is it? What product it will it over to the customer?
E-commerce, jual beli online.
Okay. How the business process?
Customer to customer.
No.
Okay.
Business prosesnya seperti apa? Bagaimana bisnis itu berjalan di dalam Tokopedia? So basically, Tokopedia some similar with another platform. It's a platform actually because they offer many services, many features that customer can do, such as payment, file and payment, pulsa, bahkan sekarang nabung emas, ya kan? Okay, jadi not just a platform that they offer to the customer and the seller, but also they have another features for the customer to make the customer easier. So they will engage to the application because they offer the features, many features for the payment. Also this one, Traveloka. Traveloka awalnya cuma pemesanan jual beli tiket ya.
Iya. Yeah.
Jual beli tiket. Kemudian they have they own payment. What is it? Traveloka Saku. What is it called? I never use the payment before because I always use bank transfer for ordering ticket. I forget. Let me check first. This is a new feature for Traveloka or maybe they have closed it. So the Traveloka is similar with Tokopedia. It's awalnya itu cuma bisnis jual beli tiket, order yeah. and buying flight tickets. Kemudian ada dia menawarkan lagi train tickets. Kemudian ada lagi hotels seperti itu, and Traveloka what cars rent, business and shuttles, and travel guides and so on. So the basic this all this application, all this technology, all this business is start with a small idea, a small innovation, a small creativity, and they built step by step. They see seberapa tinggi antusias of the customer to this to their products, and they will add the more features and get the more response to the customer. If the new feature is make the customer is confused or the UX is not really good, the customer will not use this application anymore. Okay. Jadi basically aplikasi-aplikasi ini yang pertama itu invasinya sih yang pertama itu. Dia unik. Terutama Gojek. Sebelumnya enggak ada tuh yang kepikiran ada ojek online. Kemudian Gojek ada. Terus lama-lama banyak ditiru oleh perusahaan-perusahaan lain. Pertamanya dulu kalau enggak salah di Amerika yang namanya Uber. Uber itu dulu cuma menyewakan mobil-mobil mewah. Kayak limosin gitu untuk acara-acara tertentu. Kemudian merambah ke taksi. Kemudian ini yang pink ini Bukalapak. Bukalapak ini sepertinya mulai ditinggalkan. Benar nggak? Dulu sangat sangat ramai sebelum ada Tokped yang begitu banyak fiturnya. Jadi masih orang-orang nih masih suka di Bukalapak. Kemudian ada Tokped, ada Shopee, ada kompetitor yang lain. Ini mulai ditinggalkan. Tapi kita nggak harus mencontoh juga bagaimana bisnis prosesnya, apa yang ide apa yang melatar belakangi dari terbentuknya sebuah aplikasi Bukalapak. Kemudian social lah. Girls must know this application. Not application, but this website. Mbak Risma pasti tahu ya?
Iya.
Yeah. Yeah, social lah. Basically, sells about beauty products, makeups or skincares. And social also have another product, not just a beauty product for women, but for mom and baby now. This web called Lila, kalau nggak salah, if I'm not mistaken. Jadi yang Sociola ini uniknya, mereka hanya menjual produk-produk beauty, tapi yang spesial adalah sebelum semua ada Tokped, ada Shopee, Sociola ini udah menjual produk-produk kecantikan dari luar negeri, Korea khususnya dulu. Sewaktu beauty product atau perusahaan-perusahaan Korea membuat tokonya di Indonesia, Sociola ini udah menjual duluan gitu. Dan kalau dihitung memang harganya jauh lebih murah daripada di counter. Kalau sekarang kayaknya 11-12. Kemudian ada Ruang Guru. Ruang Guru siapa sih yang dulu kepikiran bakal ada kursus online, kursus bimbel online. Ini basically for senior high school and for the college student or who wants to have a certificate skill, you can attempt the academy. Anak perusahaannya Ruang Guru Skill Academy kalau nggak salah namanya, itu juga kalau yang Skill Academy untuk mendapatkan sertifikat keahlian seperti kalau Ruang Guru kan ini seperti Prima Agama atau Ganesha Operation versi online, ya kan? Dan tetap berbayar. Oke. Yang jadi unik adalah gimana yang bisa belajar dari produk-produk ini, gimana kita bisa memunculkan inovasi atau kreativitas ini menjadi sebuah bisnis. Nah, itu yang akan kita pelajari through this semester. About information business services. Okay. Next topic-nya tentang general definition. what is business, what is ICT, and what is information business. It's just a conceptual theory. I bet you will be bored if I'm just talking about the theory without a practical. So any idea or you have any question for this topic? Maybe suggestion for this lecture will be like what, so you will be enjoy. How? Any suggestion? Ayo Mas Hernando, Mas Ali, Mbak Risma, dan siapa satunya tadi? Oh, Mbak Mita yang lagi di perjalanan ya. Oke, ada saran mungkin biar kelasnya enjoy, nggak pasif, ada diskusi terus, seperti itu. Gimana? Tadi saya ngomong bahasa Inggris jelas kan ya?
Jelas.
Bisa ditangkap semua kan ya?
Bisa.
Okay. Just raise your hand if you don't understand. I will talk in Indonesia because I'm not really good too at talking in English actually. We're learning. Okay. Semuanya asli Jember?
Asli.
Okay, so ini masih nggak pernah ke kampus lagi ya?
Kampus sih.
Bu Desi told me that you used to you actually have to in China. Is it right? But because of the COVID, the plan is canceled.
Yeah.
Gak apa-apa, jawab aja. Pakai bahasa Indonesia gak apa-apa. Pakai bahasa Inggris dicampur juga gak apa-apa. Don't be afraid. Jangan masalahkan grammar, because I'm not really good too at grammar or structure. And the structure, okay. Minggu depan kalau kita langsung dua topik bagaimana? Karena topik 1 dan 2 ini mana tadi ya topik. Nah, topik 1 dan 2 ini topik 1 terutama itu cuma
presentasi, Bu.
Oh, kalian mau presentasi? Gimana maksudnya?
Saling berhubungan. Ya, Bu, topik 1 sama 2.
Iya, saling berhubungan. Dan topiknya ini sebenarnya singkat sekali, karena general definition doang, a conceptual, so you will understand what is technopreneur, what is entrepreneur, like that. And for the second topic is just a type of informatic business, like e-commerce, like what I taught before. Or I will give you assignment. So you talk to me and I will discuss. Turn. Because this class is only 5 students. Or we have some quiz. We will have some quiz for the next topic, so I can give you assignment about these two topics, the first and the second topics, and for the minggu ketiga, for the third week we can do a presentation, an oral presentation. Okay. Or any suggestion? Any advice? Come on. Just say it. Gimana Mas Ali, ada saran? Jadi saya inginnya tuh kelas saya aktif, berdiskusi. Ini cuma 5, jadi cukup kondusif kalau untuk berdiskusi gitu maksud saya. Atau kita bikin tugas nanti, jadi kan ini karena topiknya yang pertama dan kedua ini sangat singkat. Jadi setiap topik yang ini, general definition ini, mungkin nanti akan saya beri quiz. Nanti saya upload di e-learning JTI, kemudian nanti kita bahas bareng di minggu selanjutnya. Seperti itu gimana?
Seperti itu juga discussion juga tidak apa.
Discussion, quiz.
Okay.
We have because I think the topics before the middle test is a little bit theoretical, and for the challenge is after middle test, this one. Nih, 4 ini tuh yang challenge sebenarnya, karena berbicara tentang langsung ke lebih ke mendalam tentang bisnisnya, gimana kalian akan membangun bisnis sampai dengan presentasi bisnis. Nah, rencana saya nanti UASnya ini nanti akan project. Jadi menerapkan semua teori-teori setelah UTS ke dalam sebuah project. Gitu. And for your information, you just have three chance to absent this class, or you can join the middle test, either the final test. Jadi cuma boleh absen tanpa keterangan 3 kali, sisanya harus hadir. Okay, mungkin ini udah disampaikan juga ya. So what makes different your class with regular class? Because I'm a new lecturer here. This is my first day of teaching. I want to know more about Poly J. Come on. Mas Hernando, as leader of or the captain class.
The difference is class. The classroom is a bit
more bigger.
Or
bigger, or the facility.
Or luxury.
Oh, more luxurious. Like what? You have an internet connection?
Yeah.
Internet connection. And projectors?
Yes, projector.
Okay. What else?
Hanya itu.
That's it. What about the lecturers? Before I taught you today, how the lecturer deliver the material for the course in Indonesia or in English, or sometimes in English and Indonesia mixed it up.
But the lectures is same with regular.
Oh, talking in Indonesia.
Indonesia, right? Yes.
Okay. I'm sorry for the noise.
It's okay.
Okay, if there isn't question for me, should we end this class? It's okay. Okay, just six of us. Okay, first I will stop the recording.